Hello sailors, this video is about steps and procedures in e-learning of STCW courses, which is mandatory for those who are appearing for STCW modular courses. I have completed one such course and have demonstrated the process of that course in the following video. DG Shipping has released new training circulars regarding this e-learning and online exit exams. Two circulars, one on 7th of February 2020 and the other on 1st of April 2020 was released. I have attached this circular here. The circular on 7th of February 2020 is about online exit exams and the one on the 1st of April is about e-learning of STCW modular courses. See and Job magazine have also made a publication about e-learning of STCW modular courses on 16th of April 2020. Now I will show the ways through which one could get access to this website portal. First is through Google search engine. One could simply search as e-learning DG Shipping. This will lead you to the page with several links. Of all the displayed links, the first link is the one which will lead you to the e-learning portal. Or the other way is that one could go directly to the DG Shipping website and click on e-learning options available on the top right corner of the menu bar. This will lead you to the page where you will find three e-learning options in the left middle corner. One should click on the modular courses option that will lead you to the e-learning of STCW modular courses website. Now we are in the main page of e-learning website. Here you will see a pop-up window in which you have to allow the browser to access your camera. At the bottom, all informations regarding the courses e-learning study has and minimum pass marks required will be mentioned. Here they provide you with a total of 23 courses, which includes all basic, advanced, oil tanker and chemical tanker related courses and many more. If you have an existing username and password, you could enter into the e-learning course through the options available in the top right corner. If you are a newcomer, you have to enroll using the Enroll Now option. Clicking on the Enroll Now option will lead you to a web page with the enrollment form. You will have to fill in your INDOS number, date of birth and choose your respected course among the available 23 courses. Once you have filled your details and have chosen your course, click on the Verify button. Now all your details with your name, email ID and mobile number will appear. Check for any mistakes. If there are any errors, it has to be changed in your DGCFRS profile. If there is no error, you could simply click on the confirm and submit your enrollment form. The next window shows that you have successfully registered and your login details will be mailed to your before mentioned mail ID. Check your mail for username and password. Now, to reach the login webpage, you have to click on the Click Here option shown in the webpage. Now, log in using this login details. After logging in, the webpage will request you for a face verification. Click on Capture Photo and wait for verification. If it shows you have an error, please do update your DGCFRS profile with a recent photo. In my scenario, I had to change my DGCFRS profile with my recent photo, after which I was granted access to the e-learning homepage. When you have entered into your respective e-learning course homepage, there are some important options to be noticed, which are assessments, report, program start date and program end date, within which you have to complete your e-learning course, which is normally within the upcoming 180 days. Even though I have not completed my course, I clicked on assessments to show you the error displayed. This error will be displayed even after the portal bar shows that you have reached 100% course completion. Originally, there are time durations for each courses. As I have not spent enough time in this course, I am unable to enter into the assessment and was stopped with an error statement. There are actually two time differences, one the total time and the other is the time spent. The difference between these two will be demonstrated later in this video. Now I am back to the home page and I have clicked on the ebook option. One can enroll for many courses at a time, the details of which will appear on the same home page. This is the main page of my ebook. Here you will find a set of quiz under each main heading which has to be completed. It is better to go through the ebook before appearing for the quiz. This is the model of one such quiz and it has no time limit. The set of questions for the quiz under each heading may vary from 4 to 8 and may go up to 10 questions. When you reappear for the quiz under the same heading which you have already appeared may have different set of questions. You can take a note of these questions as they may appear in the main assessment. Here my portal illustrates that I have completed 100% of my course, but when I click on the report, there is a difference in total time and time spent. The reason behind is that I have spent a longer time at the quiz than the pages of the ebook. For the course which I have chosen, there has to be at least 6 hours of time spent, after which I will be eligible to enter the assessment portal. Even after spending a lot of time in ebook, the report gives the data of spent time as 3 hours and a total time of 6 hours. When I tried to give an assessment with 6 hours of total time, I was denied an entry to the portal. Again, I had to spend a bit more time in the ebook page in order to gain 6 hours of time spent. It is better to spend a minimum of time under all subheadings and main headings, as the time spent under these will be calculated and will be displayed in the report. Finally, I gained access to my assessment portal after completing my e-learning course. Due on date within which one has to complete the assessment will be mentioned here. If one fails to complete the assessment within the given time, he or she has to repeat the e-learning course. One has to complete the assessment with a minimum of 50% marks in a maximum of 3 attempts. Failing to complete the assessment within 3 attempts will lead to redoing of the complete e-learning course. To appear for the assessment, click on the attend option. Now, the online assessment page has opened with 30 questions which has to be completed within 30 minutes for this particular e-learning course. This may differ for other courses. Most of the questions in this assessment were from the quiz on the ebook which you have already appeared and completed. A pop-up window appears when you click on the finish option after completing your assessment. The pop-up window has two options, OK and Cancel. One should click on OK to submit the assessment and Cancel to return to the assessment. After submitting the assessment, you will be directed to a page where the marks you have scored will be displayed in the marks section. If you either fail or score a little more than 50% of the total marks, attend option will be displayed in the attend section. It is necessary to reappear only when you have failed to clear the assessment. Since I have scored a better score, attend option is not displayed here. Now you can check on the final report with your marks obtained, date of submission and number of attempts after completing your assessment. One should save this PDF and has to complete this course in any one of the DG approved maritime training institutes within the following 180 days, that is the dates mentioned in your report. When I tried logging in online exit exam on DG Shipping website, it displayed an error which means one cannot appear for this online exit exam individually at home. It has to be conducted by a DG approved maritime training institute where you do your STCW modular courses. These exit exams will usually be conducted in the afternoon sessions on the last day of your STCW modular course. Your certificates will be generated by the DG Shipping once after completing your STCW modular course, e-learning assessments and exit exam. Amit suggests their fellow seafarers to complete the e-learning course before joining Amit University and Amit City College. Thank you. For further queries, feel free to write to us.